reviewer. You review it, I review you. This is my partner, Mr. It. Today, we're going to be taking a look at El Neige's review of Eragon. Neige? You okay?
Hello, I'm Il Neige, and this is what we had to watch. Coming to you from yet another new location. Think we all know why.
Except any new viewers.
After the success of Lord of the Rings, it seemed that studios everywhere were scrambling for fantasy franchises to adapt in its wake.
And other than Harry Potter, none of them really worked.
However, what set Eragon apart from movies like The Chronicles of Narnia and The Golden Compass is that, by the time the book had been published, the author was still in his teens. And our teachers would not let us forget it.
Your teachers, maybe. But then again, I was in fourth grade when the first book came out. By the time I was the author's age, no one really cared.
There was a time when the fierce and beautiful land of Allegasia was ruled by men astride mighty dragons. But the riders grew arrogant and began to fight among themselves for power.
Yeah, flying around with a great powerful beast between your legs will do that to you. Everyone's gonna start arguing over whose is bigger.
Penalty! Too obvious a joke!
So our story begins with...
Our story begins one night.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were done.
It's Jeremy Irons. He doesn't finish. He just stops for a bit.
Meanwhile, miles away...
Miles away, a young boy.
Okay, you wanna do my job for me, movie? Fine. I got a copy of Spy Kids on my shelf that's just waiting to be reviewed.
You sure you wanna do that?
Sorry, I'm still a little bitter about this whole Orthfey Alway thing.
Doesn't being an internet critic mean constantly breaking the fourth wall?
So we get our first look at our protagonist, Eragon, played by Ed Spielers, whom you might remember from pretty much nothing else.
Yeah, according to his IMDb, the only other notable thing he's done is Battlefield 1.
But before insert Bambi joke here...
Insert joke here. Shorthand for too easy, I'll let my audience have fun with it.
Where did you send it?
Poor Durza. How will you tell the king? You failed.
Eh, just call yourself George and talk about the rabbits. That usually shuts him up.
This is gonna be a running gag, isn't it?
It's at this point that we're introduced to...
Back for more!
Jeremy Irons? What are you doing here?
Trying to save this movie!
So anyway, Eragon returns home and is greeted by his... brother or friend? Maybe more than a friend?
Okay, it's been a while since I've seen this movie, but I'm pretty sure they make it very clear that they're brothers.
Oh yeah, something you might notice about the editing with this movie, a lot of the scenes don't really end. They just sort of stop. It's like they're trying to get the thing over with as soon as possible.
Wouldn't you?
Well, we eventually learn that Eragon was left on his uncle's farm as a child, and that this is actually his cousin, who's now leaving home to avoid being drafted into the king's army.
Wow! It really has been a while. I have no memory of that!
Me. But never mind these poorly realized dramatic moments, let's check in on our Mexican jumping jelly bean, which it turns out is actually an egg containing a baby dragon.
Baby dragon!
Baby freaking dragon!
If there are any references I missed, you can send them to my Twitter.
How about Norbert hatching? You know, the scene they were clearly trying to rip off.
Milk in a bag, eh? Must have been filmed in Canada.
That reminds me. Can any of our Canadian viewers explain to us how bagged drinks are a good idea?
No one could defeat them. Until a rider named Galbert Torix decided to take all the power for himself.
I'm sorry, are you under the impression that we missed the prologue?
Well, there's a good chance that 40% of the audience fell asleep during it, so... yeah!
Before you hang by a tree!
No! Let him finish.
This story appeals directly to my demographic!
Teenagers seeking advent... actually, that was the book's fans.
While back at Eragon's farm, we see the dragon is only getting bigger. Kinda makes you wonder what's taken Durza so long. I mean, first he waits all night before telling Galbert Torix that the egg hatched, and now, after what I assume is several weeks, he finally gets around to doing something about it.
The Dark One likes to buy this time, did he?
We then bear witness to a device known as Hakuna Montaja, as a period of several months is condensed into a single shot, allowing the dragon to reach full maturity and sentience in a matter of seconds.
I'm pretty sure that wasn't a montage. That thing literally grew up in the span of 10 seconds.
Now wanting to learn more about his new pet, Eragon heads over to Iron's house and starts asking questions.
Did anybody follow you here?
How big will they grow? When do they breathe fire?
Keep your voice down.
Can't you see I'm hungover?
Actually, given how he's been presented so far, he very well could be.
You mock the king in front of his soldiers.
Yes, for some reason I only get cast as characters with a grudge against royalty.
Typecasting's a bitch.
We should have been here. To warn him!
This is your fault!
But you would have met the same fate.
No! I could have saved him.
Yeah, if the dragon hadn't picked you up and flown you there faster than you could possibly have run, I'm sure you could have... Oh wait, no, you're an idiot.
Wasn't she taking him the other way at first, though?
I could have killed them.
That's the spirit. One part brave, three parts fool.
Put it together and what do you got? A prissy Heath Ledger lookalike.
Okay, points for the Disney reference, but I would have liked it to have at least rhymed.
How do you know all this?
It's called exposition, and I'm full of it.
No arguments here. Brom is definitely full of it.
Oh, and if you thought Kaiba had a dragon fetish, just wait until you hear this guy.
Please. Nobody can top Seto Kaiba in that category.
Legs a bit thin.
Good. I can use every ounce of your rage.
Was that too obvious by this point?
So, after nearly 6 minutes of solid exposition, we cut back to Durza and his army of Urgles. Basically, they're the orcs of the movie. Only instead of a legion of extras and expensive prosthetics, we get fat guys with black face paint.
So, does that count as blackface?
And just look at these guys in action. The way they commit the fantasy equivalent of a carjacking.
Didn't that shit happen all the time in medieval times?
Why can't we take quiet?
You're not ready to take anything yet.
I have skills. I can fight. My cousin, Roran and I, we've trained. With swords.
I am so glad you said swords.
This may be my slightly naive mind not knowing any better, but where the fuck were you going with that?
And like that, it's over. Like so many other scenes in this movie. Normally it wouldn't bother me so much, except that this scene is kind of important. Something you might have noticed is that most of the character development so far has been through talking. Lots and lots of talking. Now, after 40 minutes of having things told to us, we finally get a scene that doesn't rely on dialogue to get its point across. But, like so many other scenes in this movie, it's over too soon. The director probably could have had a lot of fun with this, maybe thrown in a little more back and forth, and I wouldn't be complaining as much.
As much.
Not so talented, eh, Mr. Ridley?
Okay, that's the last time I'm gonna bring up Dungeons & Dragons, I promise.
It better be.
Oh, you are just taunting me now, but no, no. I made a promise, I'm a man of my word. Empress Savina.
Wow. 23.68 seconds. Well done, Neige, well done.
So our heroes find themselves surrounded with no hope of escape. Until Eragon unlocks the mighty power of Adobe After Effects.
Power used by many an internet critic.
So Brom teaches Eragon how to unlock his hidden magical powers. He's kind of like Obi-Wan Kenobi in that way. And you know, Eragon's kind of like Luke Skywalker. Actually, Eragon's exactly like Luke Skywalker. And Arya's Princess Leia, Durza is Darth Vader, Galbatorix is Palpatine, the Dragon Riders are the Jedi. I've been watching Star Wars for the past 45 minutes.
Congratulations, Neige! You've reached enlightenment!
But wait, if we're to assume that this movie is just a straight allegory, then wouldn't that mean that Brahm is really...
Dragon Rider.
Of course.
It only explains everything! Unless Brahm is just some creepy old guy who spends all of his free time obsessing over mythical creatures.
Honestly, would either one surprise you?
Eragon.
Please don't, Sephira. I'm the rider, and I say we go.
Don't say if I were you, or tell me what you'd do. How things would be if you were in my shoes, cause you're not me.
Okay, first we had too many D&D references, now we have to keep your Yu-Gi-Oh! References in check.
So Eragon infiltrates Durza's headquarters and finds where Arya is being kept.
Eragon, you shouldn't have come.
It's a trap!
Oh, son of a bitch.
I'm just gonna save us a little bit of time here and consult the Star Wars plot outline.
Good. The sooner we get this movie over with, the sooner we can all go home.
Murtaugh leads Eragon through the mountains and they find the headquarters of the Varda.
Which one of you is the writer?
Oh hey, this movie even has its own Lando Calrissian. Go ahead and add Jimon Hounsou to the list of actors being wasted on this film.
Got it. So that puts us up to... pretty much every actor in the movie.
We've come to join you.
I see a Tron sequel in your future.
One just as underrated as the original.
And would you look at that, while Durza's face was busy rotting off, Arya managed to make a full recovery.
You look fit for battle.
I had better. I passed up a part at Resident Evil 3 for this.
Would this be an upgrade or a downgrade?
Dreamer aber sunda blacker!
Oh, you guys have gotta let me have this one!
Neige, no! You promised twice!
Let the blood rain from the sky!
Your word is now meaningless.
Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, this was a horribly thought out plan, why did I think this would work? Oh, well thank God for battles that are over as soon as the main villain is killed off.
So, every large scale battle in movies ever.
Hey, remember how you tried that spell 2 days ago and it didn't work? And how Braum said attempting a spell before you're ready will most likely kill you? And how if you die, so does your dragon? We're kind of looking at a lose-lose situation here.
I think we've already established that Eragon is an idiot. Overall, this review was pretty good. Il Neige may rely a little too much on referencing 3 movies, but you can still tell that he was having a lot of fun with this one. I'm the reviewer. You review it, I review you. Hey, did you like the video? Want to see more of them come out more frequently? Then consider donating to the Those Dudes with a Hat Patreon. For just $1 a month, you get access to Patreon-exclusive posts that include production updates and answering of viewer questions. Higher tier rewards including me advertising your URL and getting your review request reviewed by me. You can check out the Patreon page for more details, and if we can get close to my goal, then I can turn making videos into a part-time job.